2018 Audi S5 Cabriolet. Audi has set the performance bar high with the new generation A5, even with its space turbocharged 2.0-liter inline-4 engine. The A5 chassis is tied down, braking is strong, and the engine and transmission work together like Shaq and Penny in their prime. It's a complete package that puts pressure on its more athletic turbo V6-powered sibling, the new S5, tested here in Cabriolet form. The $63,275 starting price of the S5 convertible is $12,700 higher than that of the normal A5 Cabrio, a significant chunk of change that raises expectations. New with a view. This all-new S5 resembles its predecessor so closely that it looks more like a refresh than a full redesign, but Audi says the sheet metal is completely different. If the previous generation car ate nothing but cottage cheese and ran 5 miles a day for a month, like a boxer trying to make weight, it'd come out looking like this 2018 model. The more aggressive body sports wider wheel arches, a more sharply cut front end, and crisper edges where there used to be soft curves. The grille is flatter, and the headlights and taillights look sleeker and angrier. The result maintains the same general shape but presents a more hunkered down appearance. Visual distinctions between the S5 and the A5 are even less obvious. The metal trim around the lower air intakes pops more prominently, dual exhaust tips on each side replace the base car's single units, the rear gains a diffuser, the grille slats are slightly tweaked, the mirror caps are metallic rather than body color, and the wheel designs are more distinctive. The most significant difference, of course, is the engine and transmission. Power delivery. As with the new S5 Coupe and four-door S5 Sportback, the convertible has a new engine. Whereas the original S5 had a naturally aspirated V8 and the facelift of that model employed a supercharged V6, the new S5 boasts a turbocharged 3.0-liter V6. The design incorporates a twin-scroll turbocharger tucked into the valley between cylinder banks, and under light loads, it can operate on the more efficient Miller combustion cycle. This turbo V6 makes 354 horsepower and 369 pounds-to-foot of torque, increases of 21 horses and 44 pounds-to-foot over the previous supercharged 6. And while the A5 now uses a 7-speed dual-clutch automatic transmission and offers the option of a 6-speed manual, but just in the coupe, the S5 comes only with an 8-speed automatic. All-wheel drive is standard, and there's an optional torque vectoring rear differential that is exclusive to the S5. Cabin fervor. Audi has improved the functionality of the convertible top with the new model. The previous generation car had to be parked and the driver had to hold a button until the top was completely up or down. Now the top can be open or closed with a single touch of a button while driving at speeds of up to 31 miles per hour. We measured its operation at 18 seconds to open and 21 to close, both being longer times than Audi claims. The interior is exactly what we've come to expect of an Audi in 2018, with high-quality materials and plenty of fancy trim. Our test car wore a beautiful arrangement of quilted magma red leather, glossy carbon fiber inlays, soft-touch door panels, and premium metal accents. The layout is streamlined and clean, with everything logically placed and located. The buttons and dials feel great, and the fit and finish is top shelf. That puts this S5 Cabriolet at an as-tested price of $70,625. When considering the value that the A5 Cabriolet offers, that's awfully steep. The A5 might only offer a 4-cylinder, but it's capable enough to be stimulating, and the 7-speed dual-clutch gearbox is the better choice for driver engagement than the conventional 8-speed automatic in the S5. The S5 burned fuel at a 21 mile per gallon average during our testing while the A5 returned 25 miles per gallon, so there would be lower operating costs, as well. You need to step up to the S5 to get the high-performance hardware such as the available sport differential and adaptive damping, but if that's your highest priority, perhaps you'd be better off ditching the rag top and looking at the S5 Coupe or Sportback models instead.